Good evening students. Today we are going to discuss about the module 3, optocouplers. Our topic is optocouplers. Optocoupler is a solid state device to isolate the two parts of the circuit. Optocoupler combines LED and phototransistor in a single package. In electronic circuits, optocoupler is used for suppressing the interference in data communication, circuit isolation, high voltage separation, simultaneous separation and signal intensification, etc. Optocouplers can be used in either input circuits or output circuits. Optocoupler is available as IC from different semiconductor manufacturer. So this is nothing but an optocoupler which has the input interface with LED, okay, and we are using a transistor, phototransistor, and that is connected to the port pin of at 889C51. It's a microcontroller and it will be given to the again phototransistor. This is nothing but used for high voltage separation as well as the data communication, circuit isolation and simultaneous separation. Every application will be conducted in the optocouplers. Next topic is we are going to discuss about the relay. What is a relay? Relay is an electromechanical device. In an embedded application, relay unit acts as a dynamic path selector for signal and power. The relay unit contains a relay coil made up of insulated wire on a metal core, three metal armature with one or more contacts. Relay works on electromagnetic principle. When a voltage is applied to the relay coil, the current flows through the coil, which in turn generates the magnetic field. The magnetic field attracts the armature core and moves the contact point. The movement of the contact point changes the power or signal flow path. And we are using this. The relays are available in different configuration. One is we have SPST, SPST normally closed, SPDT, three types are the things we are using in the relay. SPST normally open, that is nothing but single pole, single throw normally open. This configuration has only one path for information flow. The path is either open or closed in normal condition. For normally open SPST relay, the circuit is normally open and it becomes closed when the relay coil is energized. Normally closed SPST configuration, the circuit is normally closed and it becomes open when the relay is energized. For SPDT, single pole double throw relay, there are two paths for the information how and they are selected by energizing and de-energizing the relay. Relay is normally controlled using a relay driver circuit connected to the port pin of the processor or a controller. The transistor is used for building the relay driver circuit. Here we are using the transistor. We have the freewheeling diode and relay coil. And this is relay unit and it will be connected to the load. There is a freewheeling diode is used for freewheeling the voltage produced in the opposite direction when the coil is de-energized. The freewheeling diode is essential for protecting the relay and the transistor. Most of the industrial relays are bulky and requires high voltage to operate. Special relays are called read relays are available for the embedded application requiring the switching of low voltage DC signals. This is nothing but the transistor based driving relay circuits. So next one is we are talking about the buzzer. So piezo buzzer is a piezoelectric device for generating the audio indication in embedded application. Piezoelectric buzzer contains piezoelectric diaphragm which produces the audible sound in response to the voltage applied to the device. Piezoelectric buzzers are available in two types. One is self-driving, another one is external driving. Self-driving contains all necessary components to generate the sound at predefined tone. It will generate the tone on applying the voltage. External driving piezo buzzers supports the generation of different tones. The tone can be varied by applying the variable pulse strain to the piezoelectric buzzer. Piezo buzzer can be directly interfaced to the port pin of the processor or a controller. Depending upon the driving current requirements, the piezo buzzer can also be interfaced using a transistor based driver circuit as the case of relay. Next one is, we are talking about the push button. It is an input device. Push button switch comes in two configuration, namely push to make and push to break. In the push to make configuration, the switch is normally in the open state and it makes the circuit contact when it is pushed or pressed. In the push to break configuration, the switch is normally in the closed state. It breaks the circuit contact when it is pushed or pressed. So the two types of switch configuration is coming there. One is push to make and push to break. Very good example, I can say that in nothing but in bus we are using the door closing moment. That is when switch is pressed. When the switch is pressed, then the switch is normally make or push the contact. That means the door will be closed. Again, if you press the same push button, then it will break the configuration. That means again the door will be opened. So push button stays in the closed or open state as long as it is kept in the pushed state, and it breaks or makes the circuit connection when it is released. For push to make type is closed, for push to break type is open. The push button is normally connected to the port pin of the host processor or controller. Depending upon the way in which the push button interfaces to the controller, it can generate the high pulse or low pulse. Thank you.